Hey, it's me, Destin. Welcome back to Smarter Every Day. Super Blue Blood Moon. I heard those words and I was like, that's my life now. So here's the deal. Super Moon refers to the fact that the moon goes around the Earth in an ellipse. When it's closest to the Earth, that's called perigee. And when that coincides with a full moon, bam, super moon. Makes sense. Really big, really bright. Blue moon is the second full moon in a calendar month. A blood moon has two meanings. That's when the Earth passes between the sun and the moon, and the umbral shadow of the Earth is cast on the moon, turning it red, and it looks all freaky and stuff. The second meaning for Blood Moon is when you're playing Zelda and all the bad guys that you've killed respawn and you gotta take them back down. Shout out to my boy Link. I love that game. I have a horse named Elvis. So I live in Huntsville, Alabama. There is a real... really cool model of the Saturn V rocket on the side of the interstate at the U.S. Space and Rocket Center. My goal is to get a photo of the Blood Moon as it comes down, bam, right there. That's the photo I want. I just want that blood moon and a rocket. I just think it's gonna be amazing, right? So the first full moon of the month, I went out there and tried my hardest to get photos. I tried to be aligned as the full moon rose, and they weren't that bad for a first attempt. But the problem was that particular supermoon was a rising supermoon, meaning I could stand on a bridge just to the west of the rocket.
Are your fingernails hurting?
Yeah.
My fingernails, my knuckles hurt too.
The Super Blue Blood Moon, however, was a setting supermoon, meaning I had to be on the opposite side of the rocket, deep in the heart of Huntsville, with no line of sight to the rocket because there was no convenient bridge to stand on. I want to get it right. Obviously, this requires math. You have to know where the moon is setting. You have to know where you are. You have to know where the rocket is. We're talking celestial alignment, so I called in the big guns. You remember Trevor from the solar eclipse? We did the math together.
3, 2, 1, transit.
Oh, it happened, I saw it.
So I called him and said, dude, will you come down here? Let's do some math together and let's try to figure out what's going on. We used a program called the Photographer's Ephemeris that told us exactly where the lunar eclipse was going to be behind the Saturn V.
Okay, so my buddy Jared has a drone. We did the math and we figured out exactly where the moon's gonna set and how that lines up with the rocket. It's here at All Nations Church in Huntsville, Alabama. So Jared is gonna fly with his drone and he's gonna figure out how high we need to be in order for us to see over these trees.
Coming left.
Yeah.
The bad thing about this particular lunar eclipse is that the sun was going to be rising in the east. And the problem is that means the ambient light was going to blow out the back. The rocket wouldn't be illuminated enough. So I called the people at the U.S. Space and Rocket Center and asked them if they would turn the rocket lights on.
Yeah, we was gonna cut them on about 5 seconds, but we can go ahead and cut them on right now. I'll just take a couple minutes for my guy to get over there.
The people at the church were super awesome and said I could do whatever I want as long as I didn't tear up the grass. So we had a 60-foot boom lift delivered, and Trevor and I put on some harnesses, got up in the bucket, and aligned ourselves for the shot. When we finally got 60 foot up in the air, the lunar eclipse was already underway, and all we had to do was wait for it to align with the rocket.
The moon is starting to get covered up by the umbral shadow, and at this point we are waiting to for the thing to turn red so we can get the shots with this and that.
So this is the point of this video. I was expecting a big blood moon like on Zelda. Didn't happen, but what did happen is a weird optical phenomenon that I do not understand, and it's making me a little upset because usually I have a pretty good grasp on these things. I don't know what I took a picture of. There's a line on the moon. It happens right at the tip of the rocket. When the moon comes down, as soon as the very tip of the launch escape system, which is the rocket on top of the rocket, as soon as the moon crosses that, you can see a line appear across the moon. And I don't know what it is. Look, there's a line that shows up, but it stays even with the tip of the launch escape system, the very top of the rocket. So you'd think if you planned something for a month, you'd be all excited the exact 3 seconds that it's happening, but I was confused. Like, I thought there was some kind of defect on my sensor because I could see this line, and then I was like, wait, no, I'm looking through my DSLR, so the optical path doesn't have the sensor in the way. That's an actual thing I'm seeing. In fact, I commented on it the exact moment it happened.
You see that line?
What's that? The line, what do you mean?
It's creating this weird line.
The sliver of it, you mean?
No, there's an atmospheric something that's happening right where it's touching the...
So this is my question, Internet. I took photos of a lunar eclipse lined up with the Saturn V because I thought, hey, this went to the moon, that's the moon, that would be a good photo. What instead I got was a question. What is going on? I think, is it a mirage? How could it be a mirage if it's at an angle? There's no cables at the top of the rocket. There were no airplanes in the area. This isn't a contrail. I thought it was a cloud, but it's not there until the moon gets there. The tip of the rocket's here, but it's causing a line over here. Why is it just at the tip? And then what? It's not Schlieren. No, it's not Schlieren. I don't know. So there, Internet, I have a question. Why is there a line on my lunar eclipse photos, specifically at the junction of the launch escape system on the Saturn V rocket? I don't know the answer. I would love for you to tell me the answer via Twitter. I have two Twitter accounts. I have @SmarterEveryDay, @DestinSandlin. No, this is not an attempt to get you to follow me on Twitter. I really want to know the answer. So like, if you actually know, if you could be like, hey, I actually know, and then tweet me the answer, I would greatly appreciate that. Thank you for making me smarter every day. Thanks. Bye.
All right, I hope you enjoyed this episode of Smarter Every Day. That is a difficult shot because you got the sun coming up over the other side of the Earth from the moon, and so you have the ambient light on the subject that you're trying to shoot. It's a hard shot. Would you agree, Trevor?
I would.
Yeah. So if you want to try this, I would love to see your photos. The moon is awesome. We're going back to the moon, and I just want people to be excited about it. So if you wouldn't mind tagging me on Twitter @SmarterEveryDay anytime you take really cool photos of the moon, I would love to see your work. I'll leave links down below to all the math. Trevor helped us figure all that out. I'll leave these images for the patrons on the Patreon feed. Please feel free to check it out. Feel free to subscribe to Smarter Every Day if you're into that sort of thing. Anyway, I'm Destin. We gotta get off this thing because it is cold. Anyway, have a good one. Bye. You guys have harnesses? Got harnesses so you don't fall out of the boom lift. If I put this at the very end of the video, we can say safety last.
Yeah.
Oh God, let's cut this off.